should run his ass over for playing games with us.
Son of a gun!
Hey everybody, it's your good buddy 650 Eve here, and I'm in the neighborhood of Columbus, Ohio. And this is where my good buddy R1 Kelly happens to live, but he's running scared from me because I spanked him a few weeks ago when we were both on our R1Ms. But I do have my good buddy Charles, who weighs 160 pounds on his Yamaha R1, and he wants to face me on the BMW HP4 here. And that should be pretty interesting because I weigh right now 235 pounds. I've gained some weight. So we're going to see what my good buddy Charles can do versus my HP4. We're trying to avoid some rain. His R1 looks nice, sounds nice. He has the Two Brothers exhaust on it, I do believe. Yes, he does. Two Brothers SR1 exhaust, the same one that I used to have before my bike was bronked out. And now my SR1 exhaust sits in my basement collecting dust.
Snatch your soul, come fill it up and we snatch your gold.
This guy weighs 65 pounds less than me. That's the only reason why he keeps up like that. Only reason. Well, what do you think of the beatings you took? You know?
What?
It's not, no, that it's you. It's not that fucking bike. It's you and the weight difference. If it weren't for that weight difference, I would have left you for dead a long time ago. Typical Midwest rain that we got called in, but we're not too far from Charles's house. But I really don't want to get super soaked with all my gear because I still have to drive 2 hours home.
Quick flood, drip, go woo on a bitch. 5790, spent the coupe on my wrist. $multi-million, I'm a fool with the hits.
This is my guy, Austin, on his beautiful 2010 or 11? 2011 S1000RR, and he weighs 130 pounds. That's literally a legit 100 pounds less than me. He's going to be facing off with my good buddy Charles on his R1. Charles weighs 150, right? 160, so there's a 30 pound difference. But yeah, we're going to see what happens. Charles gives me fits when he's on his R1. He doesn't recognize the weight difference. In fact, Charles beat me a couple times on my HP4 solely because of the weight. But we're going to see what happens when Austin puts the SmackDown on him, puts foot to ass. We're going to find out in a second. Oh, yeah, you will, because of the weight. Hey, I put Austin on this bike, you're done. If I put Austin on this bike, you are done. I do believe it. Okay. Austin, will you pilot this bike and put us and shut his lights out for me? Please. Say goodnight, my friend. You better be lucky Donnie Brosco's not here. Tony Kelly was afraid to race me today, so he shows up on a one-wheel crazy vehicle when he was supposed to. I know. I tell you. So afraid to race me, he shows up on this thing. I should run his ass over. I should run his ass over for playing games with us. This is Columbus, the short north area, I believe it's called. Look at him, almost ran into the guy. Let's see this guy. Like it's stir fries with it. Oh, Charles got the first one. Charles on the R1 won the first race. So Charles beat the S1000 with a rider that weighs 20 pounds less that's running MR12 racing fuel. Wow. That was you, right? Fair race? Looks like Austin got that one. So it's currently a tie. Austin has won one race. And my good buddy Charles has won one race. And it's been pretty good races, fair starts. On that last race that Austin won, he actually wheelied and was able to recover from that to victory. And I must admit, Charles has a big plate on his hands right now to beat that S1000, seeing that it's running on racing fuel and Charles is not. That one, him. So, okay. So Austin has won right there, 2-1. You can see, I'm with my good buddy Austin's S1000RR, and because of the crazy weight difference, I lose to Charles on his R1. Yet Austin, on the same bike, just beat him twice. All right, so we got Austin on the R1M and Charles on his R1. Speed it up, speed it up. Here they go. I'ma pull that coupe at the race. Austin got him. Austin got him. Austin got him. Like I knew he would. I told you guys, size and weight matters. It absolutely matters. That man was able to jump on my R1M and beat him, whereas I've lost to him. He's destroyed me on my R1M. Okay, here they go again. Give him 2 bucks. 2 bucks. as I've been saying all these years, size and weight definitely matter. When I'm racing a person, I am 99% of the time racing against a person that weighs a lot less than me, has a smaller body, doesn't have as broad shoulders, and that really hurts me when I'm doing my SmackDowns. I continue to do it because I love doing SmackDowns, and I also love, you know, showing what these bikes can do on the channel, but I just wanted people to understand how weight really does matter. My good buddy Austin on my R1M weighs just 20 pounds less than Charles, but they're roughly the same size. And Austin was able to give Charles a 2-bike lead and still come from behind and beat him. Now, both of those bikes, the R1 that Charles is riding and my R1M, have their ECUs flashed by Superbike Unlimited. So the performance-wise, they're pretty much the same, with the exception that my R1M has Rotobox carbon fiber wheels. So that does make a slight difference, but I think the majority of the difference came from just weight. They were pretty much equaled out, and you could see that my R1M was just a faster bike. That was a
blast.
Yeah, you like it, huh? Yep. Yeah. Yeah. At one point, you gave him a 2-bike hit, and you still won, right? Well, sweet. We had a great time testing out these bikes and demonstrating that size truly does matter when it comes to racing, as I've been saying, and as my good buddy Brock has been saying all this time. So, you made it this far in the video. Go ahead and smash the like button. Subscribe to the channel by clicking subscribe. New videos are always uploaded to my channel. Stay tuned for more, and as always, thanks so much for viewing.
Hey, this is for all my kiss stealing, wheel and dealing, limousine riding, jet flying, dripping, son of a guns. Woo!